Hi, my name is Sam Altiz. Next couple weeks, you're going to be learning how to do some conduit bending in the shop. So we're going to go through some of the most common bends that you need to learn. There basically are four bends you will need to learn. One is the 90 degree bend, the offset bend, saddle bend, and the 4-point saddle. There's also a minor one called a box bend, but that's also considered an offset. So those are the four major bends that we will be learning today and in the sequence of videos. Today we're going to start off with the 90 degree bend, which is the most common bend used in industry. Conduit is used to run your cables in compared to residence where you use Romex or MND90. In commercial industrial use, you use conduit. This is the raceway that's used to run your cables in. So this is what we'll be learning in the next few labs. So before you can go in the lab and bend your pipe, we need to learn the principles, terms, terminology, and some calculations required so that you can do your bends. So for us to bend conduit, obviously we're going to need a tool, and that tool is called a conduit bender. Here's an example of the tool you'll be using in the shop. This is a half-inch EMT conduit bender. Also in the shop, you'll notice that some of your conduit benders might have this device that goes on the bottom. It prevents it from slipping when you're holding the bender in the upright position. Conduit benders come in many different sizes depending on the EMT pipe you're bending. EMT comes in many different sizes, half inch, three quarter, 1 inch, up to inch and a quarter. So as you can see, I have a few different benders here. So this is the half inch EMT bender that I had in my hand. Right beside it is a three quarter inch. As you can see, the shoe is a little bigger. This is called a shoe. And right beside it is a 1 inch EMT bender. Once again, like I said, they go up to an inch and a half. We will be learning today with the half inch bender and showing you all the different parts of the bender that you need to know.
We've zoomed in on a half inch bender to indicate the four principal parts of a bender. You have your hook where your conduit will go and it gets hooked onto. So your conduit will go in this hook here and hook onto it so you can do the bends. You have your shoe that provides and makes the bend. You have your heel where you put your foot on to put pressure, and you have your handle that you use to pull back to make the bend. To demonstrate the other parts of the bender, I will remove the handle to point out some of the other features that you'll need to learn about the bender. You'll notice on the bender it has some markings. It says that it's a half inch EMT bender. You'll notice that it has an arrow. This arrow is where you line up your marks to make your 90s or your offsets. You also have a notch. This is what you use if you're doing a 45 degree bend for a saddle. It's called a rim notch. And you also have a star mark if you want to do a back-to-back 90, as it marked on this indicator. Also on this, you'll find the degrees of bends. So as you bend your pipe, you line up the bottom of the pipe with these lines, and that is a degree of bends that you have given the pipe as you bend it around the shoe. So you have 10, 22 and a half, 30, 45, and 90 degrees. Also on the bender, you'll see a marking that tells you that stubs 5 inch and up from the arrow, which basically means that when you put a pipe in here, the pipe will take up 5 inches. So if you want a 10 inch stub, you will make your marking 5 inches away from the 10 inch and start from there. We will demonstrate this later on when we do our 90 degree bends. So this is a half inch EMT bender markings. There's also a 3/4 inch that I wanted to point out, and the difference between the two, you'll notice it's a much bigger shoe, but it says 3/4 inch EMT on it. What's different about the 3/4 inch, it also, if you flip it around, it'll say that it's also designed for half inch rigid. Rigid pipe is much thicker wall, therefore it will not fit inside the hook of a half inch EMT bender. So you would have to use the next size up bender for a half inch rigid pipe. If you had a 3/4 inch rigid pipe, you would have to use a one-inch EMT bender to put a three-quarter-inch rigid pipe.
Now that we know the major parts of a conduit bender, we're going to start talking about a little bit about the terminology and the calculations that we have to do to bend conduit using our bender. So there's some simple terminology that you need to know. When you do a 90-degree bend, it's really called a stub, right? So a stub is basically a pipe with a 90-degree bend that usually goes into some kind of box or device or panel, and you're bending into that panel. This distance from here to here is called your stub, which is usually the shortest 90-degree bend of the pipe. The other part of your pipe, so from this section to this section, is called your tail. So you have your stub and you have your tail. A couple of terminologies is also is takeoff. So stub, takeoff. And we talked about the stub takeoff. We said it's on the bender. This stub bender has a stub takeoff of 5 inches. So it's going to take up 5 inches when it does the bend. Right? And over here is going to have your back takeoff. So basically, when you bend your 90-degree pipe, when you bend 90 degrees, you actually gain some length in the pipe overall. So if you had a piece of pipe, and in our labs, we're going to use 5-foot lengths of pipe, so that's roughly 60 inches, sorry. You're going to use a 5-foot piece of pipe. If you mark it at 10 inches, and you want a 10-inch stub, you're going to mark it at 5. You're going to deduct 5 inches from the beginning of the pipe, so when the pipe gets bent, it actually gains 5 inches to give you your overall 10 inches that you require. So we were talking about gain. Each bender has its own gain. So if you're dealing with a 1/2-inch bender, a 3/4-inch bender, a 1-inch bender, each individual bender will have a gain. Also, like each bender will have its own take-up. A 1/2-inch EMT bender has a take-up of 5 inches. A 3/4-inch bender has a take-up of 6 inches, and a 1-inch has a take-up of 8 inches. And take-up meaning that when you put the pipe in the bender, it will draw pipe from the tail, therefore making it a longer stub. An example would be, if we want a 10-inch stub here, and we're going to use a 1/2-inch bender, you need to make the mark 5 inches from the edge of the pipe to get a 10-inch bender. So you wouldn't take your pipe and put a mark at 10 inches and just bend it there. You actually have to put the mark at 5 inches. You hit, line that up with your arrow of your bender, and when you bend it, the stub or the final product will be 10 inches in height. That is what is meant by take up. It takes up from the tail to give you the amount that you require. So if you were doing a 3/4-inch pipe, your mark would be different. It wouldn't be at 5 inches. If you wanted a 10-inch stub, the take-up is 6 inches. So technically, it's going to take 6 inches from the pipe, so you would put this mark at 4 inches. And the take-up of 6 more would give you a total of 10. So depending on what bender you use, you have to make a calculation and a marking different for each bender. But for this lab, we're going to be using a 1/2-inch bender. So we will leave this at 5 inches as a mark. Now we're going to take a piece of pipe that's basically 5 feet long, and we're going to measure 5 inches from top. But before we do that, we'll just verify that this is a 5-foot piece of pipe, and it is. So we have 60 inches, which is equal to 5 feet, and I'm going to mark off 5 inches on my piece of pipe. When bending conduit, it's always good to have a Sharpie, make your mark and continue your mark right around the pipe. Get in the habit of doing this, because when you're doing bends and offsets, sometimes you have to twist the pipe 180 degrees and you won't be able to see your bend. So it's a good idea to mark your pipe all the way around where you're marking it. Now that we're ready to bend our 90 degree and we have our mark on it, we're going to take our conduit and we're going to place it inside the hook of the conduit bender and line up the mark with the arrow.
As you can see, we have our mark lined up with the arrow on the conduit bender, and we're ready to make our bend. But we'll need to bend this on the floor to get the correct way of bending a 90 degree stub.
So we got our pipe ready, the mark on our arrow. We're gonna put it on the floor and we're gonna get ready to bend to make sure we don't lose our mark. You put 1 foot on the pipe, 1 foot on your heel, and you're gonna push down on your foot and pull back on the pipe to get the bend. So we're gonna bend it, keep pressure even, and you keep going till you get a 90 degree bend and the pipe is almost perpendicular to the floor. This comes with a little bit of practice to get it perfect. You're gonna remember when you take this off, you're gonna have a little bit of spring back, so you always wanna go a little bit more than 90, so when you take the bender off, it'll spring back to where it's supposed to be. So you do that little 90 like that, lift it up, and you've got your 90 degree bend. We'll do that once more in a close up so that you can see a little closer. One. Here we are again, a little closer look on how to bend it. You're gonna line up your mark with the arrow on the bender. So we'll put the mark on the arrow. All right, so you're lining the mark up with the arrow, not with the front of the shoe. Remember, mark with the arrow. Once you set that up, tighten up the grip, put pressure on the heel. You don't always have to have your foot on the pipe, you can just put pressure on the heel and get ready to bend. As you pull on the pipe, you keep putting pressure down with your foot till you get to 90 degrees. A little more to go. Almost there. So we're basically at 90 degrees. When I lift the handle upwards, it'll release the pipe and we'll have a nice 90 degree bend. We were aiming for a 10 inch stub, and as you can see, we have perfectly 10 inches on our stub. So by marking the pipe at 5 inches from the edge and putting on the arrow, it has given us a 10 inch stub as it was marked on the bender. Each bender is slightly different. So whenever you get a bender, you should test a few pieces to see that the markings on the bender are correct and that they are accurate. In this case, they are. They told us it was a 5 inch stub and it worked out perfectly. Usually when you get a bender for yourself as an electrician, it'll be your own personal bender. You know all the little ins and outs of that bender, what it can and cannot do. In this case, the ones we are using in the shop are all the same type of benders, so all of them should give us a 5-inch take-up when dealing with a half-inch piece of EMT. One. So we've just proven that in our bend, we marked our pipe 5 inches from the edge and we made a 90 degree bend, we end up with a 10 inch stub. So that confirms our value on the board that says for a half inch pipe, the take up is 5 inches. So when you take your overall length of pipe, which in this case was 60 inches, make a mark 5 inches from the edge and bend it, you will get a 10 inch stub. So once again, let's confirm that. We will put that pipe there, take a measurement of the pipe, and if you're able to see this, you'll see that we have 10 inches. So that confirms once again our half inch has a 5 inch take up as it's marked on the bender of your use. So half inch has a 5 inch take up, so your bender in the shop will have a 5 inch take up. What we also have talked about is our back take-up. So how much did we lose in our pipe? Originally we had 60-inch piece of pipe, but we deducted 5. So therefore you started with 55 inches. If we were to take this pipe now and place it the other way and measure it, you will find out that we have roughly 52 and a half inches. All right? So you take that 52 and a half, and we had 55. But now we got 52 and one half. We lost 2.5 inches. So our back take-up is 2.5 inches. So if you take the two values that you gained, in other words, you had your 10-inch stub, that was made up from your 5-inch markup and your 5-inch take-up. So 5 inches plus your 5-inch take-up gives you that 10-inch stub. You also now have a 52.5-inch tail. So we take our 10-inch stub plus our 52.5-inch tail for a total of 62.5. We started off with 60. So this is where our gain comes in. We gained 2.5 inches. So the gain for a half inch bender is 2.5 inches. Now this is for this bender. Each bender will be slightly different. So it's important that when you get a bender, you always use the same kind and you figure out all these gains and deductions, so that when you do your bends, they'll be accurate every time you make a bend. So for this half inch bender that's in the shop that you'll be using, it has a 2.5 inch gain, which happens to be the same amount that you lose in the take up. So whatever you lose in take up is the actual gain in the stub. All right, so let's recap once again the parts of your bender. We have the shoe, we have the hook where your pipe goes in, you have the heel where you put your foot on, the handle that you pull on as you put the heel pressure on. You also have all the markings on the stub. You have your arrow that we use this time to do the 90, and we have the notch and the starch, which we will talk about later on, and you also have all the degrees, which we will talk about further in other video lessons. But until today, that is how we do a 90-inch stub, and hopefully that you understand. If you have any questions, approach your professor. I'm sure they'd be happy to help you out.